Hi, I'm David Friedmann. I'm a neurotologist at NYU. We started doing the Slim Modiolar Electrode as our standard electrode in 2016. And so we've been using that both in children and adults since that time. I think the Slim Modiolar Electrode really represents sort of incorporating the best of what cochlear implant technology has to offer in sort of the modern era. And by that I mean being able to offer patients full cochlear coverage, perimodiolar placement for optimal stimulation of discrete channels with minimizing channel interactions and hopefully with that better spectral resolution, but also the potential for a really slim electrode that's going to be able to preserve intracochlear structure and acoustic hearing when it's present. So we're really sort of not sacrificing on either side in terms of preserving structure and preserving hearing, but also giving maximal coverage. It's worth mentioning that I think for the Slim Modiolar Electrode, it's a terrific workhorse cochlear implant for many, many patients. It's not appropriate for all patients. Patients with abnormal anatomy, revision cochlear implants, some sorts of congenital malformations, because of the slim nature of the implant, those are cases where we don't use this particular electrode array. But for your standard anatomy cochlear implants, this has become our go-to cochlear array. From a standpoint of the surgical procedure, we initially had some difficulty with understanding sort of how this design change was going to impact how we do cochlear implant surgery. So there was some considerations that were different from prior generations, namely having an external sheath, and the actual insertion process, while still incorporating elements of AOS technique, no longer included a stylet. It was this external sheath. So there was a bit of a learning process as we gained experience with the new electrode, as I think there always is when there's something new introduced. I think that it's fair to say that there are these nuances that need to be paid attention to, and that there is a learning curve with this electrode. The reason I think it's worthwhile and the reason why we have continued to use it day in and day out is really related to what we see as the ultimate benefit to patients.